working currently now. So.
How do they make it live? Somewhere else?
Yeah, so we're streaming it all over there. And we're live.
Hey guys, we're here with Kyle Connor. Kyle, so is this your first year doing this?
This will be my fourth year.
And what are you looking forward to this year in particular?
Mostly got new snow machines this year, swap brands, and then probably more snow is going to be pretty convenient.
Are there any obstacles or anything you foresee happening this year?
Aside from the normal stuff of, you know, wear and tear. Heating issue last year. 2 years ago, we did have some issues, but last year it wasn't an issue at all.
So, are you excited for all the new snow we got?
Yeah, it's gonna be nice. It is nice. No.
Did you have any sponsors you wanted to thank?
Yeah, we got Arctic Cats, kind of our biggest sponsor, Norcoast Mechanical, and Alaska Boiler and Burner, some of our bigger ones, Cruise Construction. So I could go on, but that'll do.
And so, who are you racing with?
My partner this year is Jeff Krause. I think he's done it 4 or 5 times, so he's hanging out around here somewhere.
So you guys are the same kind of
area? Yep. Our first year together, but
awesome.
Thanks.
It was pretty good. It was warm on the Yukon, sunny, blue skies. I mean, you couldn't ask for better weather last year, but the snow conditions were a little bit minimal. This year, the snow conditions are a lot better. There's snow the whole way. There's snow in the Farewell Burn. It's one of the best trails we've seen in a long time, so it's going to be a fast race this year.
Have you guys had any late obstacles in the past?
2015, we had minimal conditions in the burn. A lot of dirt, mud. So I think we're already ahead of the game right now on that. So
we just ran to McGrath and back. System and so we know that section of trail. the other day clean there and back. So I think getting that out of our system is going to be huge for us.
Clean eating, a lot of physical activity, working out, running, cardio, taking in lots of water, preparing ourselves mentally, which is why we ran the McGrath and back over the weekend to visually see the trail and know what we're up against and how fast we can run through certain sections. Going to be brutal. We did the first day twice, so we're good.
I think my biggest obstacle is not hitting anything the first day. I've been kind of notorious the last 3 years, and I've smacked some stuff. So my biggest obstacle this year is going to be not hitting anything. And I think if we can do that and run a clean first day, I think the rest of the race is going to go well for us.
How long have you guys been racing?
This is my fourth Iron Dog.
I think this is 8 or 9. I can't keep track anymore.
What's your favorite thing about doing every year?
I love the cold weather. I love the 45, 50 below zero and just like freezing to the point of hypothermia. The camaraderie between all the guys and meeting up with everybody and coming to this and going to all the other events in the
a lot of new blood coming in now. Legends are now starting to retire, like Scott Davis and guys like Mark Carr and Scott Fayo, John Fayo. And, so we're seeing new guys coming in, which brings
kind of a new element to it, a new pace. Everybody's running a new pace now. It's a lot faster pace than what used to be run, and so that's kind of why everybody's. There's no win anymore. It's either all out or nothing. So
that's why that running clean. A lot of the damage done to these sleds are pretty much done the first day. If you could hold them together and get them to the finish line, you're going to do pretty well. These sleds are built tough, but it takes one tree to take them out.
You're not gonna win the race on the first day, but you sure can lose it.
We'll lose it.
That should be the motto of the Iron Dog.
Do you guys have any sponsors?
I know Team Arctic Alaska. It's his team. It's our team. That's a big one for us. Big State Mechanical, UA Local 367. Climb is one of our biggest sponsors. Climb is by far supports us, bar none. It's the best gear. Backs us like no other. So those are our biggest sponsors right now.
Thank you guys.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
there's a perfect storm brewing. With a forecast calling for high pressure
and
speed. Mother Nature makes the rules in the 2017 Iron Dog. It's going to be a wild ride, so you'd better batten down the hatches. Channel 2 News coverage of the Iron Dog is sponsored in part by Northern Air Cargo. Teamwork that delivers.
Iron Dog presents the Flying Iron Freestyle Show, fueled by Monster Energy. Backer, Friday, February 17th at 7 p.m. and Saturday, February 18th at 2 p.m. in downtown. Monster, Odom Corporation, and Willowa. Don't miss the Turquoise Boy concert at Willowa following Friday's show. Please drink responsibly. For more info, visit flyingironshow.com. Iron Dog presents the Flying Iron Freestyle Show, fueled by Monster Energy. Watch X Games medalists Corey Davis, Joe Parsons, Heath Frisbee, and local writer Tim Beckner. MC'd by Paul Thacker. Friday, February 17th at 7 p.m. and Saturday, February 18th at 2 p.m. at 3rd and East. GCI, Monster, Odom Corporation, and Willowa. Don't miss the Turquoise Boy concert at Willowa following Friday's show. Please drink responsibly. For more info, visit flyingironshow.com.
There's a perfect storm brewing. With a forecast calling for high pressure and speed. Mother Nature makes the rules in the 2017 Iron Dog. It's going to be a wild ride, so you'd better batten down the hatches. Channel 2 News coverage of the Iron Dog is sponsored in part by Northern Air Cargo. Teamwork that delivers.
Is good. I'll just do one more announcement, and then we're gonna get started in like the next 2 minutes. Yeah. Hey, can I get your attention, please? Everyone, please take your seats. We are going to get started here in about 2 minutes. So they're ready to serve salads and get the meal going, and we're gonna get the program going right away. So if you would please take
Ladies and gentlemen, to the 2017 Hall of Fame and Race Drawing Banquet. My name is Michael Newcity. I'm with Newcity Entertainment Group, and we are very happy to be here with you for a second year in a row. This year, we have 35 pro-class teams. That totals 70 racers. 27 rookie racers, 8 all rookie teams. Our pro class racers this year.
Volunteers are the engine that makes the race possible. Whether staking trails or hanging banners, every job is key and every person is appreciated for their time and their talents. Let's have a round of applause for our volunteers this year. The Iron Dog is a very lean organization. They have a year-round staff of just 2 people and 1 seasonal hire. With the board of directors who strive to make the most out of every resource. Let's have a round of applause for our board of directors and what the Iron Dog organization is capable of with just a staff of 2 full-time employees. At this time, I'd like to introduce Mr. Kevin Kastner. He has been leading the organization with the help of a great operations manager, Laurel Hickle, since 2010.
A long program. We've got 35 teams to draw for tonight. A very small staff, and I want to just give a quick shout out and appreciation to Laurel and Sarah, wherever you are. Let's give them a round of applause. They work very hard along with me to make this thing happen. And, you know, in my role, I'm contractually required, if you will, to give attention to everyone involved. But I'm truly pleased to say that our appreciation for our sponsors, it goes beyond just a contractual agreement. We have strong relationships with all of our partners, and we like long-term relationships. And I just want to say that, you know, we're blessed to have the support of global manufacturers, small mom-and-pop fabricators, all different kinds of industries that support this race. And it can't be said enough how much we really sincerely appreciate the support that everyone gives to this race. And so I'm just going to go through this very quickly and talk a little bit about some of our partners that make this possible. So you've heard about the racers who are key. You've heard about our volunteers who are absolutely essential. And, of course, the staff and board. And it's the sponsors that make up that fourth leg that keep this thing afloat. So our premier sponsors, these are the folks who have contributed the highest level of sponsorship and in-kind support, along with critical relationships, experience, and teamwork that continues to drive our success. So everyone plays a slightly different part here, whether it's a cash or it's an in-kind. The amount of logistics that we go through is immense, and so folks like Northern Air Cargo who do all the heavy lifting, along with others like Linden. And after 34 years, you know, we're lucky. Partners, again, large and small. Some of us have been receiving support, or some have been providing support, I should say, since 1984, and some have just joined us this year, but it's important to note that everybody matters and makes a positive and lasting contribution. Pro-class sponsors, they also make up a very important category. We have lots of folks in this category that, again, provide cash or in-kind support, you know, grants, the City of Fairbanks, the Municipality of Anchorage, and many, many others that you see here. We couldn't do it without these folks, and whether it's raffle prizes or RV rentals, there's so many moving parts, again, thanks to our pro-class sponsors. And from you know, everyone at Iron Dog, I can't say thank you enough on my end for the years of support. Incredible. So this is for our sponsors. I want to say thank you for all of your support. And I'd also take a moment here to recognize, if you've noticed in the last few years, we've included longer trips. We're going over 2,000 miles. We've included other communities. So it's important to recognize these cities, boroughs, and communities, and villages, and agencies all over the state that make this possible. I mean, the amount of people that we touch as an organization is pretty intense. And this is just a list of some of the folks that, you know, that have been a part of this. We're crossing 2 military installations. We're working with Native corporations, federal groups. You know, it's a pretty monumental group. So we're really grateful for the key support that these communities, every small village and every large city makes it possible. And when it comes to supporting the Iron Dog, nobody has matched the level of commitment in the history of the Iron Dog to making this more than just another snow machine race. The Alaska National Guard has been engaged for 10 years with early support, starting with support for a team, and to today where they're one of our top advertisers and longtime supporters and a partner in our race. Let's take a quick look at the Alaska National Guard with this video.
The Alaska National Guard is a premier force driven by core values, empowered by trust, dignity, and respect.
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 Ready and relevant for service to the state and nation.
We fight in America's wars, we protect our homeland,
and we build global and domestic partnerships.
There are nearly 4,000
highly trained, dedicated airmen and soldiers
in the Alaska Air and Army National Guard in communities throughout the state.
We have Alaska Guardsmen who are currently deployed overseas. We respond to state emergencies when called.
We perform rescue missions regularly.
And we have valuable relationships with local, state, and interagency partners.
In our military position,
mechanics, nurses,
engineers, pilots, firefighters, and more.
We work in finance, human resources,
supply, transportation, and medical clinics.
In addition to many other offices and shops,
Guardsmen travel to support missions. We participate in exercises and train to be experts in our field.
And we engage in events that support our local communities.
The Alaska National Guard is a military team where we are challenged by tough training to build warriors who are ready for real-world contingencies.
It is a priority to develop safe and resilient soldiers and airmen who are motivated and honored to serve our state and nation.
We are trusted at home and proven abroad.
I am the Alaska National Guard.
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 I am.
I am.
I am.
I am a citizen soldier.
I am a citizen airman.
I am the Alaska National Guard.
We appreciate the support that you've shown us over the years, and let's give them a round of applause. Thank you. And we appreciate your service, and to tell us more about the shared values, the mission, and the meaning of the Iron Dog and the Army National Guard's relationship, I'd like to introduce Major Selena Herndon. Please give a warm welcome and a round of applause for Major Herndon.
Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Kastner, staff, and racers, we're so proud to be here tonight. It is always a pleasure to be here and sharing the 10th anniversary of our kind of partnership with Iron Dog. We're also very proud of all that you do to support our state, our communities, and the Guard through your race. We applaud and recognize your hard work and efforts that goes towards making this event very successful. What a nice banquet tonight. Your values and the initiatives you support directly align with and for those reasons, we couldn't be more proud to associate our organization with yours. Like your organization, we pride ourselves on promoting diversity, teamwork, resiliency, and building the most professional military force in our nation. Your race and racers not only promote Iron Dog, but you also promote the Alaska Army National Guard, enabling us to showcase our training opportunities, as you saw in the video, our career capabilities, and our teamwork concept, guiding us all towards leadership positions within our community. We look forward to following the racers on your demanding journey. Just remember, it's not about the length of the race or the rewards at the end. It's rather the loyalty to your teammates. One thing that we like to think about every time we go into a force of nature, Be ferocious, focus on your goals, and don't stop until you've been successful. So I'd like to thank everyone for having us up here tonight. I'd also like to thank our recruiting force, Chief Dave Bain, Specialist Kim, Specialist Lyon, Specialist Lemaire and her date, Sergeant Major Velosic. We are all so proud of everything that you do and what you represent, and we're just happy to be a part of all that you do. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Just one more time, if we could please recognize all of our sponsors. I know it's difficult. We zip through that, but if we could just show a round of applause. You know who you are. We appreciate everything you do. If we'd have one more round of applause for our sponsors, I'd really appreciate that. Thank you for your help. And thank you, Major, we're sincerely grateful for your outstanding commitment and that of the Guard and what you've shown to the Iron Dog over these many years. And while we're on it, let's quickly talk about some of the other community programs that we've been developing since 2011. And beyond the critical support that our checkpoints and villages provide, Iron Dog is also committed to returning the favor by engaging students across the state. And this goes kind of in partnership with the Guard. And along the trail, we engage through student exchanges, through projects, and just like the live streaming. But thanks to GCI and Raven Alaska Air, we've got some support for a student media production and some student exchange that's going on the whole race. So we have live coverage tonight, Flying Iron Friday night, the start, Nome, and also the finish. So we're really grateful for that. This is South Anchorage High School's third year in actually producing content for the Iron Dogs. So let's give the team in the back of the room a round of applause for their support tonight. So this year we have King Career Center, we have South Anchorage High, who's here tonight. We have Houston High School, who will be joining us at the start and the finish. And then McGrath School, this is their second year. They're flying on their own. They raise their own money. And some kids from McGrath are going to come and join us and be a part of the events in Anchorage as well. And one of the key community projects is giving. Since 2011, the Iron Dog has been raising funds through our raffle. And by the way, if you haven't got your raffle ticket tonight, I highly encourage you to do that. By the time we got to Fairbanks last year, they were sold out. And Wendy's over here in the corner, she's got raffle tickets, but I'll move on. What I wanted to say about that is we've donated just under a couple $100,000 in the last few years to local charities. And as a community of racers and a community of Iron Dog fans, we choose military and veteran organizations, and we've given quite a bit of money, and we're hoping this year to do that again for our current partner, and you'll see USO listed right there. And we're hoping that this year USO So to tell us more about our partner this year, what I'd like to do is actually just introduce the director of the USO Alaska Center, Tara Mogan. If you could come up and tell us a little bit about the USO. Let's welcome Tara.
I love that song. First, I'd like to thank Kevin and the Iron Dog Board of Directors for selecting USO Alaska as its charity partner for the 2017 Iron Dog Race and Raffle. And we greatly appreciate the unwavering support of our military from the corporate and civilian communities throughout the state. It is through the strength in America's service members by keeping them connected to their family, to their home, and to their country throughout their service to our nation. From the moment they join through their assignments, their deployments, and as they transition back into the communities, the USO is with them all the way. Our trademark USO tours bring America and its celebrities to service members who are assigned far from home to entertain them, but also to convey the support of our nation to them. We operate USO centers, roughly 200 around the world, at or near military installations, in many airports and in combat. boosting activities, and all the hugs that they can stand 365 days a year. We provide programs and outreach services to assist military couples and families coping with the unique challenges of military life. We offer assistance for wounded warriors and their families and their caregivers. We humbly escort families of the fallen. In Alaska, we pay particularly close attention to the emotional well-being of our troops and their families, and collaborate with military and community organizations to create positive experiences and provide healthy outlets to make their darkest days a little brighter. The USO is not part of the federal government. We are a congressionally chartered private organization. We rely on the generosity of individuals, organizations, and corporations to support those activities, and we're powered by more than 30,000 volunteers worldwide. Within our first year of USO operations in Alaska, we opened a new USO center at J-Bear and the first ever USO wellness center. We supported more than 200 events for our military. We also outfitted a USO recreation room for those serving at the Northern Warfare Training Center near Black Rapids. And we brought the Show Troop Entertainment, Miss America, Craig Morgan, and numerous athletes to service members and their families throughout the state. 2 weeks ago, and we're working on our third at Fort Wainwright, scheduled for late summer. We will also deliver 600 backpacks with new school supplies to the Coast Guard kids at Kodiak, and holiday toys to military families throughout the state. These are just a handful of ways that we support Alaska's military, but none of this can happen without your help. So on behalf of the USO and our military community, I want to thank our service members for their service first and foremost. Thank you, Iron Dog, as well as the individual and corporate sponsors for helping us to support them. We are honored to be your charity partner for this event. I wish all of the racers a safe race with lots. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Tara. Let's have one more round of applause for the USO tonight. At this time, I would like to invite the Iron Dog President of the Board, Mr. Jim Wilkie. He will induct our Hall of Fame recipients tonight.
The Iron Dog began in 1984, making this our 34th year. 10 years ago, we began to recognize those people who were the most instrumental in our success, and we created the Iron Dog Hall of Fame. Since that time, we've inducted 22 people, 21 individuals, and one corporate sponsor, and tonight we'll induct two more. It's my privilege to introduce the first Hall of Fame inductee, and before I get several current Hall of Fame members here tonight with us, and I'd like them all to stand to be recognized. I'm not sure how many are here, but I would like them all to stand if they could, please. Thank you, folks. As I mentioned, the Iron Dog started in 1984, and many of you, not in the Hall of Fame, were also here during that time and helped at the very beginning and got it off to a pretty good start. After a few years, however, the Iron Dog was in kind of tough shape, and it looked like it was on its last legs and might completely go out of business and forever. solidified things, got it back on track. If it wasn't for him, the Iron Dog would likely be gone. And I'd like to have Hall of Famer Harriet Fenerty come up, and she can speak to her experience with him and during that period.
Thank you, Jim. Good evening, everybody. Wow, what a room full of incredible people. When I was asked to introduce the next inductee into the Iron Dog Hall of Fame, I was pretty emotional, so bear with me if I have to gather my breath and take a moment to get my words straight. When I was asked to introduce Jim tonight, I went to my Iron Dog file. I still have it after 21 years. That's why I wore my badge of honor tonight, because I've been involved for 21 years, and Jim was the man who hired me back in 1996, an unknown, a girl who knew nothing about racing. I had done events before, but I'd never undertaken a race. I didn't even understand the difference between minutes, seconds, places, machines. I was a rider, but I was not a racer. The important mementos in my file, and one of them was a 22-page to-do list. 22 pages on an Excel spreadsheet that was categorized by things such as things to do next year, next week, tomorrow, by the minute, by the hour. And Jim was a list man. So when I went to work with him in 1996, he had been on the board for a year already. He had started his journey in 1995. He immediately sought to correct the course, as they say on ships, that are a little off compass. Not a good thing. So seeing that our Iron Dog was in need of a total makeover, he structured a complete reorg. New bylaws, new rules, new articles of incorporation. He fixated on a budget's bottom line, working to erase a deficit of $40,000. Imagine that, $40,000 of red ink. An event that had been going on for 10 years had amassed a $40,000 deficit. His calm nature helped smooth the explosive issues that stemmed from racer frustrations and sponsor disappointment. Participation continued to dwindle, as it had by 1995. Aaron. He popped the bottle. In 1995, Iron Dog hit its all-time low. It had fewer than 20 teams in the lineup in pro class. So Jim went to work. He put a team approach together. He tackled the rules. He recognized in order for the race to flourish, the rules were going to have to change. He predicted before anyone else that incorporating a new race course in 1998, under Jim's direction, Iron Dog changed its course, and it created some magic. We went from Wasilla and Big Lake to Nome and to Fairbanks. It was now an across-the-state event. Jim formed an enthusiastic team of board members, staff and racers, sponsors and fans, communities, and so much more. They stood by him shoulder to shoulder from 1995 through 1999. He assembled a roster filled with some heavyweights from across the state and beyond. Their task was to help him breathe new life into our. In 1995, this event, the Iron Dog, was just 10 years old. Jim forecast a turning point for the race, and I, for one, am happy he invested himself as all in. Jim didn't know it then, but we know now, because of his great work, we are able to stand tonight, shoulder to shoulder, to enjoy the kickoff of our 34th running of the world's longest snow machine race. Magic is being made in 2017. Little did you know, huh? Accomplished for us, all of us in this room tonight, for the Iron Dog family. Thank you, Jim, for your tremendous commitment and generous spirit. It must be said, you have truly saved an Alaska gem. Please help me welcome 2017 Hall of Fame inductee, Jim Palin.
Those were awful kind words, but I think the main thing that I want to get across is, oh, before I even start, Kevin said I had 30 seconds to give comments, but Kevin, I'm sorry, I'm going to go over that a little bit, not much. Anyway, I think it's extremely important to say that all those words of praise are greatly appreciated, but the whole issue was a we project, not me. And I'm very, very proud of all the people that we brought into the program to help it go forward. There were 20 plus directors that appeared on the Iron Dog Board of Directors, and they had a lot of diversified achievements and activities. And you know what, I just have to recognize a couple of them anyway, even though there was 21. Ray Debingham. I've known Ray for probably 50 years through the utility business, and he's been a diehard, great supporter of the Iron Dog for a long time. And his compadre, Randy Moss, he was on our board as well, and he was a real great asset to it. Chris Michelson, who's not, I don't believe he's here today. Elmer, I believe he's passed, but he was a real old-timer in the Iron Dog field. And Jim West from Nome, he was a great asset to us, even though he had to discontinue his pull tabs for us, but he still was a great guy. And of course, as the board got involved in taking care of things, you know, you have to appreciate, number one, what the board does, number two, what the staff does, not necessarily in that order, and then all the volunteers and the sponsors. And like the National Guard, I think, is just a great thing for today's event. I look at the National Guard sponsorship as a win-win-win situation. Win meaning it's supporting the Iron Dog, it's supporting the villages, and it potentially helps the kids in the villages consider joining the National Guard. And I just think that's a great opportunity for them. Without the volunteers, and of course the staff, and Harriet was the jewel that we eventually retained as our executive director, and she did a bang-up job, as you all know. And the sponsor issue is always very, very important. And now I love to see the National Guard involved in this and others in a great way. And as a 9, our racer drawing was held at the Matsu Resort in Wasilla. And one thing I'll never forget about that is I spoke after the mayor, who happened to be my daughter-in-law, and I said after that, I'm never speaking after her again. But anyway, the encouragement by my family members, of which several are here, all my kids are here, and I got several grandkids here, and none of the great-grandkids, which is fine because I'm way too young for all these great-grandkids. But the family support is extremely important, as well as my employer, who probably didn't realize how much time I spent on Iron Dog issues, but I did. It's a great honor for me to be part of the Iron Dog Hall of Fame, and I think I share it with all the former directors and the staff, the volunteers, the sponsors, and the racers. And I've had the opportunity to meet a lot of people throughout the state. Somebody asked me the other day, did you ever travel along the Iron Dog Trail or the Iditarod Trail? And I said, well, no. However, I've refereed basketball several years ago in Unalakleet and Nome. So I guess I was... two of my boys have been participants in the past and continue to be, and obviously we're always rooting for them and to be very successful and safe and enjoy your ride, but be safe. From a personal standpoint, I've had the opportunity to meet a lot of wonderful people as it relates to the Iron Dog, and that's been extremely rewarding to me. When we changed some of the rules, two major rules were changed. One was you can pick up parts, you can get parts, and before it was you cannot, you take what you're going to use and nothing further. We changed that. It was if you cannot place the rule, don't have a rule. And the other one was changing the route to include Fairbanks to expand the exposure of the Iron Dog to other parts of the state. And that, with that, and then looking at today's function, I mean, this is a hell of a good attendance and support for the Iron Dog, and it's great to see. The work that we did, and I emphasize on we, I believe took the Iron Dog to another level, but since Kevin and Laurel have taken over with Jim and his board members, and obviously sponsored it to a much bigger level, and I look and anticipate that it'll be going to a much higher level yet. With that, I'd just like to thank everyone.
Our next inductee is truly one of those people who needs no introduction, but I'll go ahead and give an introduction anyway. Scott began racing motorcycles in Soldotna and soon graduated to the big time and started racing here in Anchorage and the fast guys. By the time his motorcycle career had ended, he had amassed 18 motocross statewide titles as well as a number of flat track titles. And Bob Kowalki decided that maybe it would be a good time for him to start racing in the wintertime and do a little snowmobile racing. So his very first event, his very first big-time snowmobile race, was the very first Iron Dog, in which he finished a really close second. After that, his record is unmatched in the Iron Dog. He only retired a couple years ago. We should have put him in the Hall of Fame a long time ago, but he kept racing. And... was competitive right to the very end. Outside of a couple races that he didn't finish because of mechanical and two that he didn't enter, he ran, I believe, a total of 30-some events. He He has a record-tying 7 wins, 7 seconds, and 6 thirds, and his record is unmatched. I'd like to welcome Scott Davis to the table. Scott, just a moment, please. We have a short video we'd like to run. I forgot about that, sorry. But we do have a short video on Scott that we're going to go ahead and play right now.
I borrowed one of my dad's friends.
5 or 6 years old, and we were had borrowed one of my dad's friend's old 14-horse Ski-Doos, and we were riding it around, and I drove it into a pole, and we had to buy it so because I had damaged it. So that was my first introduction to snowmobiles. You know, I first heard about Iron Dog probably the early 1980s. There was rumors about starting a race and racing from Manana to Nome like they did back in the 70s. Yeah, I mean, we were second the first year and won second the first full race, full-length race we won. And over the next 32 years, I raced 30 races, 21 top threes, 7 wins. Yeah, I think the race has always been, parts of it have always been scary. You know, like some years the tides and the wind will crack the sea ice and take it out 10 feet and, you know, to the water. And if you fall in there, you're done. And, I mean, there's stories of guys crossing, you know, getting out in Norton Sound and in around in areas and getting wet and having to swim. And my kids weren't born when I started doing this. And John Fale's kids weren't born when we started doing this. So, you know, I mean, we've watched Cody Barber, Corey Davis, you know, I mean, Brad George, all them young kids, you know, running around chasing their dads, you know, at the starting line, and now they're, you know, competing for wins. Once you win, and I tell you that feeling, that elation that you get crossing the finish line, is pretty addictive, you know? And isn't the only reason that I race, but. You know, we race to win. We're racers. That's what we do. We want to win every time.
Without question, the greatest Iron Dog racer of all time, Scott Davis.
Thank you, Jim. Wow, I, you know, for a small town kid like me, could be the best in the on the planet at racing a snowmobile. You know, that's kind of what drove me for years, and I have a really short memory is the other reason. So, congratulations to Jim. So I invited a lot of people here, Regina did, to be with me tonight to experience this, and I have to give a shout out to some people that. Bob Kowalki, Steve Deptula, without those two, I never would have got started in Iron Dog. Bob funded me when I couldn't afford to get out of Sterling, and Steve's the one that actually got me into Iron Dog, and I appreciate that. Lifelong friends, got to thank my two incredibly talented kids, Corey and Carly, my beautiful wife, Regina. I need to thank my partners over the years. I counted it up tonight with Harriet. I had 10 of them, and but I just want to also thank over the years all the volunteers that opened their homes to all the racers and donated their time. All the people in the early years, Bob and Jim, that spent countless hours on their own dime to put on the very first Iron Dog, because it was really just a dream. You know, in the early 80s, it was just a dream. Nobody thought they could even, you know, it was possible to do that, you know. So, and it's evolved, and I have to give a shout out to all you racers. Good luck, be safe, thank you.
Let's have one more round of applause for our Hall of Fame inductees tonight. You guys ready to draw some ping pong balls and see who's going to race this race? At this time, I'd like to welcome Laurel Hickel and Tara Mogan back to the stage to assist in tonight's race order drawing. And the way that this is going to go tonight, I am going to draw for our pole position, our very first team to leave the starting line. And we will have them come to the stage. They will welcome their sponsors or thank their sponsors. And then we are going to draw in order of three. So I will call three numbers at a time, and I will have three teams stage right here. I will introduce you by name as you come on stage. You'll have about 60 seconds to thank your sponsors right here at this microphone. Ladies and gentlemen, the first team leaving our start line for the 2017 Iron Dog Classic, team number 16. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear a round of applause for team number 16, Todd Minnick and Nick Olstad.
Yeah, well, here we go. Well, I guess first and foremost, I'd like to thank my wife, Sherilyn, for putting up with me and make sure everything's going good on the home front, so I appreciate that, hon. Mountain Dew, Kickstart, Black Label, thanks, Mike. Appreciate that, taking care of us. Walker Evans, Climb, I appreciate it, Sid. Thank you very much. Big Dipper Construction, thanks, Mom and Dad. Hatcher Pass Players, thanks, Jimmy and the gang over there. Appreciate you guys.
Edge Fitness, my sister, for attempting to get us in shape. And then Eric Quam. Thanks a bunch, Eric. We really, really, really appreciate you. Darcy, thanks for letting him help us. He's doing double duty. His sleds, our sleds. Thanks a lot. Al Palma, thank you very much for helping us out. Really appreciate everything you do for us. And Gilbert, he's our head tunnel polisher. Does a really good job, so thanks, Gilly.
I'd like to thank my wife. Happy Valentine's Day to everyone. No one said anything yet. Perk Up Espresso, Ron and Arlene Miller, Polaris Engineered Lubricants, Udelhoven, The Original Signs, and Anchorage Sheet Metal. And have a good race.
Our next three teams tonight, team number 18, team number 9, team number 31. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for team number 8.
Sweet, not a bad draw position. Just want to thank a couple sponsors here. Team CC, Corey, always helping us out. Definitely the go-to man over there. Dirtworks, Panco, Climb, hooking us up this year. EMC Engineering, Trail Tank, Woody's, Orion Construction, Gates Belt, and
First of all, thanks to my wife. She's kind of my rock, so without her, I couldn't do this. A couple other people, Todd Palin, over the years, he's really, really helped me out. Let's see, Dr. Levine, where are you at? If it wasn't for him, somebody else would be standing up here with Andrew right now, so I really appreciate that. If you guys got back problems, he's the man to see. Corey, a couple of years he's been helping me. And I know we're missing some people, but all the teams that are out there this year, breaking trail up to Puntilla numerous times, cutting logs, alders, all that stuff. Thank you very much. Have a good night.
Ladies and gentlemen, team number 9, Josh Plum and Jordan Starr.
All right, well, first and foremost, I'd like to thank our family and friends that support us over the years. My wife and our family and Team CC, Corey and Barbara, Climb, Sid, really been helping us out this year. Chris Mannion, Fox Shocks, SCS Unlimited, Plumline LLC, my parents, For Honor Corporation, Alaska Frontier Services, Craig Taylor Equipment.
Really putting us in the spotlight this year. As well. Kurt Menzer, he's a big help with us this year. I'm glad to have him here tonight. Dennis Coots, flying all the way up from Maine. He's a big supporter of us now. Tim Bloomer, pilot, Alaska Hand Oval Shoulder Specialist, S&P Auto Care there in Eagle River there, Aero Works of Alaska, Remax of Eagle River, Door Systems of Alaska, Rigid Industries, RPM Composites, and all our friends and family that helped us along the way and get where we're starting third this year. So appreciate it all. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Team 31, Remington Lessard and Tim Lessard.
I want to thank Skidoo. Chase Toys, our Skidoo dealer back home, Josh and Brian. Compounding Solutions, Eagle Industries, Team CC, Trail Tank, Gates belts, Woody's traction products, proven design products, Wilderness Skidoo, RPM composites, Snow Shooters, LaFlame Racing, Will Skornick Racing, and especially my wife and my daughter Paxson. My wife Carrie kind of talked me into coming back up here. This is my third time entering. I never thought I'd do it again, but she thought it'd be cool to race with my son once he turned 18, and here we are.
This. My girlfriend Lexi helped me in the garage. Scotch Recreation, Grip and Rip Racing, Fly Racing, Triple Nine, Ben's Auto Sales, Snowtech Magazine, Climb, RX Goggles, C&T Power Sports, Over the Top Performance, A&R Auto Sales, Fastenal, Whiteout Technologies, High Gear Suspension. That's it.
Our next three teams drawn, team number two, team number three, team number five. Team number two, Micah Huss and Ryan Sodasanti.
We like to thank a lot of the volunteers, people in the villages helping out. Buddy, without them, I mean, we wouldn't even have a race. Everyone with the Iron Dog, all the countless hours you guys put in, National Guard. Like to thank all of you as well.
I'd like to thank a couple of sponsors. First of all, our biggest sponsor is obviously Team Arctic Alaska, Micah. He supports so many of these Arctic Cat teams and helps all these guys wrench, and he just endless hours in the garage. It's unbelievable what this guy does, not only for our team, for all the other Arctic Cat teams. So Team Arctic Alaska is obviously our biggest sponsor. Big State Mechanical, Neisser Construction. You know, Climb, I can't even begin to tell you how good of a sponsor Climb is. I emailed Sid the other day and told him I couldn't get this coat. And had it shipped to my house, and I just got it yesterday, just out of the blue, and it was like unbelievable. Thanks, Sid, for that, by the way. Vision X, you know, I know that I see a lot of racers are starting to run Vision X lights now, and I think the word's gotten out. Vision X has got a good product, and those guys have treated us really well. Some other sponsors, Local 367, Arctic Cat, Project 907, Fox Racing, Zugger, you know, Zugger, everybody knows Zugger. He does everybody's shocks. There's a whole list of sponsors that I don't even want to get into all of them until the finish line. So I just want to thank all of our sponsors, everybody involved with this year after year. So I want to thank Laurel, I want to thank Kevin, and everybody else that's put this thing together. This is an unbelievable event, and I can't wait for this thing to get started. I'm ready to get on the trail.
Leaving the start line in the sixth position, team number three, Shane Barber and David Spain.
I don't know how to act. I've never left in the top 20 before. It's a little different for me. Thank you.
Leaving our start line in seventh position tonight, team number five, Nick Petito and Jared Vaughn.
Yeah. First, I'd like to thank my wife for taking care of the house and the kids while we've been hanging out in the garage for hours and hours. Denali Dental, they were our big sponsors this year. Thanks to them for Doctors Association, H&K Sheet Metal, Adventures in Eye Care, Big Dipper Clothing, Northern Lights Avionics, Be Alive, my folks, Mark and Lynn, thank you for all your support. Rachel Kidwell, she's been big time in the garage with us this year. Donald Koontz, he's also been doing a lot of our fab work for us. I'd also like to thank my grandmother for coming up here from South Florida to watch us run this year.
Yeah, so you guys have heard this before, but definitely want to appreciate my wife. Hasn't given any guilt trips and been nothing but supportive. Now, after the race, that might change, but other than that, I'd like to thank Polaris Racing. Let us do a last-minute switch. They've been nothing but supportive. Definitely helped figure out what they've done. But other than that, Sports and Spinal Injury Clinic, Tequila 61, Northern Petroleum Products, Support Services, Tom Winstein. He's always been a big help, and he definitely helped us out above and beyond this year. And I'd like to thank Colored Art also.
Team number 6, team number 4, team number 25. Team number 6, Brad George and Robbie Shackle.
Thanks everybody for being out here tonight. Thank my family, my wife, my mom, George family, big help. Team CC, Danny Guayco, great job on our shocks this year. Alaska Line Builders, huge help. IBW backs us. HP Unlimited, Delta Western, Avis, Workman Racing, Anderson Concrete, Welder, Lone Pine, John Eicher, amazing welder, Alaska LED, Fast Cash.
Right on. I'd like to start out with thanking Team CC, Corey Conquest, and Danny Guayco. You guys have been there all year long when we need your help. It's awesome. And Barb, thank you so much. Skidoo. Then my dad, Andy George, Mr. Lube, my mom, everybody in my family, and Robbie's entire family. Thank you, Trina, for dinner every night this winter. And Robert Ian for letting me sleep in your bed all the time. Thanks, buddy. And Alaska LED, actually, we got a couple different lights going on. Penn Jersey Drilling, Wasilla Napa, Motor Fist, GES, Jason Moore and Rob Strick, Team 12. You guys have helped us out more than once, and it's greatly appreciated. Thank you so much. Alaska Cab, congratulations to Jim and Scott. That's awesome, you guys. Yeah, Iron Dog, all the volunteers for Iron Dog putting this whole thing together. Everybody goes out there and breaks the trail, stakes the trail. Thank you guys so much. Looking forward to a great year. Thank you.
Departing our starting line in the ninth position, team number 4, Bobby Minnie and Dan Tebow.
I want to start off by thanking my wife for letting me do this again. My aunt and uncle for coming up from Seattle. The National Guard for helping out again this year. Polaris Industries, Soundworks, Matt Spurnack. Doesn't matter what time of the night it is, I can bring shocks over and he'll take care of it. Might not have a smile on his face, but he'll do it. Valley General Energy Services, Big Dipper Construction, not only for the support with this, but also keeping me around all summer. The guys from Vision X, thanks Nick, Kurt. Mountain Dew Black Label, and thanks Mike Dropic. Al Palma, Eric Quam, Gilbert, thanks for coming over there and helping us last Friday. Corey, Sid with Climb, thanks a lot for the help with that. And Larry Levine, thanks for everything. The garage, getting dressed in the warm garage up there in Big Lake all winter. Thank you. And this guy for coming up again.
How's it going, guys? I'm just glad to be back up here. This race is, like, ridiculously awesome. I'd just like to thank Fine Line Interiors and Zollinger Racing Products, Gates Belts. They stepped it up for me down south and up here and stuff like that. So they've been doing great. Nate and Rich over at Fly, they step it up big time for me. Walker Evans, those guys are huge. 139 Designs, Chris. Team 16 for letting Dan tag along because I can't be up here. So thanks for that. Taylor Leasing, AK Mow and Snow. Woody's, Lead Dog Helmet Lights, 999 Optics. Dietrich for letting us stay at his place in McGrath. And yeah, just glad to be here.
Departing in 10th place, team number 25, Tyler Bogert and Brandon Burmeister.
First off, we wanted to say thank you to Iron Dog and all the supporters that helped get this race started for us. Without you guys, we wouldn't be here. We'd also like to thank Dr. Bradley Sutz and his wife from Alaska Oral and Facial Cosmetic Surgery for being our official sponsor this year. Without you guys, we wouldn't be here, so thank you. My fiance, Talisha, and my parents, and the rest of my family, and daughter's family as well, thank you guys. You know, without you guys and holding down the houses when we're out training and late nights in the garage, we wouldn't be here, so thank you. Nick Olzenak and the rest, thank you for giving us the parts we need and getting us on the trail and keeping us there. Fox Shocks, Michelle Webb, Chepo's Mexican Restaurant, Altitude Chiropractic for keeping us in line and everything working the way it should. Delta Constructors, Motor Fist, thank you, Brock, for keeping us warm and dry out there. Magic Metals, Vision X, Specialized Transport and Rigging, Ricky at OFT, and special thanks to Team 9. Thank you guys for all your guys' support and giving us some hints, even though it's not all of them, but hopefully it'll get us to Fairbanks.
And I would like to thank Team CC, Danny, Corey, Shocks, Project 907 for killing it on the wraps this year. They look super good, and it's nice to have some nice graphics to show off all the sponsors. There's a lot of sponsors out there that help these teams to keep us going and get us to Fairbanks. So we're going to be in Fairbanks this year, and we'd like to see everybody there. So thank you.
Team 36, Team 12, Team 14. Position, Troy Conlin and Ryan Folsom, Team 36.
I want
want to thank my friends and family. My wife over there, she made it out this year, which is good. Really stepped up and helped us out to run again. Team Industries, Polaris Racing, Stud Boy, Auto Trim Design, Walker Evans, Darby's Performance, Fit Body Boot Camp, Interior Mobile Welding, Allstate, Jeans Chrysler, Pagoda, Wilson & Wilson Construction, Northland Wood, Santa's Stitches, and Hutch's Mobile Service.
I'd like to thank my wife, Kendra. She's been doing a great job running the page and keeping us all up to date. I'd like to thank FXR Racing. Do great. Just give us the great gear that we always expect from them. Delta Power Sports, TKI, RPM Composites, Rehab Wraps with just a outstanding wrap this year. Can't wait to show it off tomorrow. Zucker Shocks, Motion Industries, Speed Cell, North Star Performance, Last Frontier Barbershop, Fox General Store, Holiday Parks, Baja Designs, and Custom Canvas.
Departing in the 12th position, team number 12, Jason Moore and Robert Strick.
So before we get started, I want to happy Valentine's Day to my wife, Noelle. Thanks for letting me race again. I want to thank my grandparents, my parents, for supporting me. Over there, thanks for the support through the years. Penn Air, Carrie Ann at Penn Air. Cabela's, Daryl, thank you. Joe and Sandra, thank you for the help. Donald and Gold, thank you for the help, you guys. We appreciate it. All the volunteers along the trail, you guys really make the race happen. A lot of them aren't here, but we appreciate it very much. Our pilots, Manzi, Dad, Brett, Aaron with Oakley, Alaska, and I'd like to thank my Uncle Rich for racing years ago to get us started on this race.
Well, so hopefully that's a good sign, right? All right. So I need a big thanks to my wife, Tara, for putting up with me and Rob over the years, and Noelle for putting up with me and giving me all that coaching advice over the phone, telling me I need to get out and ride and work out more and all the other things she told me. Appreciate it. Huge thanks to Brad George and Andy George for helping me out, kind of mentoring me throughout the year. And Micah Huss, always looking out for me. Big thank you. Appreciate it. And we want to thank Big Lake Arctic Cat, Wasilla Arctic Cat, Truckwell of Alaska, Tony Webster, Zucker Shocks, and last but not least, Alaska Skydive Center. Thank you.
Hey, and everyone back home watching, hello. I know we got some friends in Alabama watching.
Departing in 13th position, team number 14, Casey Boylan and Brian Leslie.
So first off, thanks to my family, Casey's family too. They weren't too excited when we first told them we're going to do this, but in the end, they're happy for us and been behind us. So start off first with Team CC, Corey, Danny over there. Can't do it without you guys. I think I've called Danny more than anyone I've called in the last 2 months. So thanks, Danny. Ski-Doo, Motor Fist. IBW, not only for a paycheck, but they're always behind anybody. So thank you. Sheila and Jerry Buffington, Bill Bishop, huge sponsor. He's a big one. We couldn't do without him. So A2D, Alaska Snowmobile Salvage, Alaska LED, Chris, you're awesome. Anytime we got any light problems, give him a call. He'll hook you up. Primary Residential Mortgage. And Three Bears, Alaska. Thanks, guys.
Yeah, for the rest of our sponsors here, John McDonald, everyone at Carlisle, thank you.
Anchorage Yamaha. They hooked us up with Hyfaxes. Yamaha, Flyweight Racing, Western Power Sports, Hair Addiction, STR Alaska, Ben Cruz, Gates Belts, 139 Designs, Chris, do a killer job on our wraps this year. Fine Line Interiors, Doug, he knocked it out of the park, got our bags, everything set up, knew exactly what we needed. My grandparents back home, Danny Guaco, can't really thank him enough, called him a lot, and Chad and everyone who's given us a lot of support and a little bit of guidance there. And Brian's family, my family, and my girlfriend, and everyone for supporting us. We thank you.
Team 41, Team 37. In the 14th position, Team Peter and Richard Swenson.
Well, first off, we just want to say thanks a lot for having us back this year. I think a lot of it was our decision to come back, but my wife and my two kids for supporting me again, second attempt. So all the racers who were out there on the trail with and all their encouragement along the way. Last year we made it to Nome. A lot of them told us, you know, come back, give it another stab. So here we are again. My partner here, he's also my boss. So he let me take the time off from work. That's always a plus. And he's out there. Problem solvers, so we work through it, and we're going to make it back to Fairbanks. We do have some sponsors we'd like to thank. Trail Tank helped us out with some pricing on our tanks. Team 31, Grip and Rip. I don't own a sled that doesn't have a Grip and Rip brace kit on it, so thanks for all your guys' help with that. Friends and family along the trail. We got some sponsors in Ruby who take care of us both ways, so hopefully this year we get to see them on the second way back. Jay and Ginger Lima, friends and family in Nome. Jerry Miller, he puts us up when we're in there. And everybody else along the way, all the fans. We couldn't do it without you guys.
Yep, I'd like to also thank my wife, Prize, our other good prime sponsor. Andy Swenson, great partner, and good luck to everybody else out there.
Yep. See you in Fairbanks.
Departing in the 15th position, Team 41, Corey Davis and Ryan Simmons.
My little buddy is at home sick tonight, so it's just me. I'll keep her short. My dad for working on the sleds while I was down playing on some ramps. Al Palma for making our tanks, my pilots Gary Eoff and Doug Dixon for flying for me and for making my bags. Doug, thank you. GCI, have them on board again, appreciate that. Alaska Energy for always supporting me with all my endeavors, thank you.
Heading out in the 16th position, team number 37, Matt Halala and Stan James.
Thank you, guys. Our biggest sponsors for Matt and I would be our wives. And that's they're the ones who've let us do this and been there making dinner for us while we're coming home at 2 in the morning and things like that. The second biggest sponsor we got is Alaska Foot and Ankle Specialist. I need to thank Matt for putting me up here. Climb, they hooked us up with a lot of good gear, Alaska LED. Team CC and Danny, they're wonderful. Best sled we've ever ridden. Grip and Rip, want to thank Adrian Abrams for flying for us. Trail Tanks, we might not be the fastest team out there, but we're going to look good, and that's thanks to Kerry. He did our wraps. And Stud Boy, thank you.
I just wanted to say it's a real honor to be a part of this all-Alaskan event as a lifelong Alaskan. I'm not going to be able to even follow in the footsteps or a shadow of it from other guys from Soldotna, but I'm a little late to the game, but this is such a fabulous thing, and we got to thank our trail class team that we did this a few times together, Eric Campbell, John McCormick, and Rick Carver, for inspiring us to be a part of this pro class event. So anyway, thanks a lot.
Team 49, Team 32, Team 39, Clinton and Chris Van Wingerden.
Hey, good evening. Thanks. Glad to be here. I just had to start with a question. Jason, is that beard part of your face no fog protection or what? I mean, that just. Anyway. Hey, I just want to say thanks to all the teams, volunteers, and sponsors of this great race, and just really happy to be here. Special thanks to family and friends that have invested their time, resources, and most importantly, you're very appreciated. Thank Polaris Race Department, FXR Racing, Elka Suspension, our dad, Doug Synthetic Lubricants, thanks for all the oil and custom machine work that you do for us, Dad. Gorilla Fireworks, Arctic Fox Steel Buildings, Alaska Fireplace and Accessories, Special Events Alaska, Diversified Tire, Fine Line Interiors, Anchorage Sheet Metal, Alaska LED Industries, Hatcher Pass Polaris, and Zugger Shocks. I also have a special thanks to Team 10. You know, Mike Morgan, Chris Olds, you guys have been a huge help to us. Really appreciate it. Appreciate all the guidance and getting us set up on these Polarises. And most importantly, want to thank my wife, Callie, and my kids, Reese and Miles, for their devotion and commitment to this team, which is making the event so fun. So thanks a lot.
I think my brother covered all our sponsors, but also want to say thanks to the guys in the back doing the online video. My wife's at home watching, and that's awesome. Want to say thank you to her, Heather, taking care of the kids, and she's a huge support for me in this endeavor, and I think she has just as much desire for me to do it as I do. So want to say thanks to you, and thanks to my brother running again, and yeah, so cool.
Departing in the 18th position, team number 32, Rob Cleary and Dave Hausbeck.
Hey, thanks for he's here from Michigan, but we made it. Last year, Dave told me that he was going to do this, and I thought he was crazy. And this year, all my friends think I'm crazy. So thanks for having us. Dave's going to cover the sponsors.
Thank you, Rob. I want to thank everybody from the great state of Alaska. I want to thank all the staff, all the volunteers, everybody who makes this possible, all the other racers that have helped us get up to speed. Definitely the Alaska National Guard. Without you guys, this would not be possible. I want to thank friends of ours, Mark and Jack Hirschman. They drove my pickup and trailer up 4,000 miles from Michigan, so thank you, Mark and Jack. It really support. Thank you, Larry, Matt Spurnack, Jason Allward, and numerous racers and residents. I really appreciate everything. Woody's Traction Products. And after I got back last year, Rob asked, you know, I was talking to Rob about possibly running it this year. And he says, how bad is it? Well, without lying to my good friend, I had to put a spin on it. So I said, Rob, it's one lap. How hard can that be? So with that, then he's like, okay, Alaska, how do you stay warm? Just buy climb gear and be done with it, and you'll be good. So that's our goal, is to finish in Fairbanks on the lead lap. So want to definitely thank Randall Moss. House, his garage up. Without Randy, it would not be possible. So thank you, everybody. Can't wait to see everybody on the trail. Thank you.
Departing in the 19th position, team number 39, Chad Dowell and Shane Grindle.
All right, we got a ton of sponsors. But first, I got to thank my partner, Shane. He's got about 98% of them. My girlfriend Shauna and Shane's girlfriend Danica. We have Chase Toys, Euclear, Crescent Lumber, Lakeside Burner Service and Community Fuels, Matthew's Brother, Revzilla, Team CC, Triple Nine Belts, Ski-Doo, Zimba Drywall, Jackman Lumber for the use of their truck to get up here, Davis Dirt Works, Climb, and Eric Robbins for driving the truck up here from Maine.
I'd like to thank Chad, my friends and family, Danica Lockhart, my girlfriend, for everything she does. Rolly's Bar and Grill, Young's Lobster Pound, K&B Automotive, Lockhart Building and Remodeling, H.O. Bouchard, Bowen's Tavern, Carmel Electric, J.M. Brown Construction, Woody's Traction, Grip and Rip Racing, Maine Fuel Solutions, Rainwater Solutions, DeShield Transport, Belfast Variety and Belfast Variety Route 52, and Moral General. And last but not least,
team number 22, team number 45, team number 28. Start line in the 20th position, team number 22, Kurt Steiner and Dieter.
Hello, I'd like to thank my wife, Judy, first of all, for putting up with me. Got to be up here on Valentine's Day, and she's not here. Kind of stinks, but she's been very supportive of this. Articat, my buddy Dennis Drankson at Planet Power Sports. Carl at Big Lake, Articat. My buddy Unch always seems to be able to take care of us when I'm up here. And Midwest Doors.
I'd like to thank DHS Green, Winning Edge Graphics, Sukup Manufacturing, Spud Small Engine for a ton of help, all the parts. Winning Edge for the wraps, an amazing of us for the last 4 years, and my wife that's let me miss out on 4 years of Valentine's. Thanks. Yep.
Departing in the 21st position, team number 45, Barney Anselmint and Dietrich Nikolai.
I'd like to thank my wife and kids for their support and family and friends. And Devin Holmberg, our pilot, Regal Airs pilot, and Dan Tebow for his help. And also like to thank Dr. James Hodges, Dr. Paul Sayer, Frankie Sayer, Nick Newman. Good luck, everybody.
All right. I'd like to thank our top sponsor, Donald and Gold. Big thanks to you guys. MTNT, Big Lake Power Sports, Climb for the best gear, Alaska Air Transit, Alaska Commercial Company, Stud Boy Traction, Action Signs and Graphics, Alaska LED Industries, Northern Petroleum, Nikolai Village Council, Takana Village Council, and personal sponsors, Gary Egress, Tommy Taguchi, Ricky Castro. I'd like to thank our pit crew in McGrath, Gary, Donnie, and Nick Reeder for helping us wrench on our sleds. Big thanks. And last but not least, my wife and kids. Thanks for helping me make this dream come true. And better get used to it because we ain't done yet. Thanks, everyone.
Departing in the 22nd position, team number 28, Jason Gunderson and Josh Norum.
All right, first I want to thank Skidoo for helping us out with getting sleds this year. Compos up in Fairbanks, Climb for the awesome gear they provide, Gunderson Painting, Stacy Roy with State Farm, Ron Service and Towing, Jeans Chrysler, Construction Machinery, Auto Trim Design with making the sleds look good, my parents, Debbie and Gary Gunderson, my uncle Steve Gunderson, Bryce Benson for helping us wrench on the sleds, and my girlfriend Courtney Roy, which also helped us out of the gym and gave us some workout plans to stay in shape. Thanks a lot.
I got Team CC, Sourdough Express, Vision X, Fleener Paper, Walsh, Keller, and Sharp, Chris Merrick, Allstate, Hale & Associates, Lavelle's Tap House, Big Rays, my wife Jamie Norm, parents Dave and Debbie Norm. Thank you.
Team number 8. Team number 10. Team number 27. And gentlemen, departing in the 23rd position, your 2016 defending champions, team number 8, Tyler.
Hey, everybody. So obviously, thank you to everybody here for coming out for this. And along, I first got to thank my wife and my awesome kids that are unfortunately not here because they're a little too chaotic to probably be in a closed room like this. But then as well, we got some amazing sponsors, and there's some amazing people behind those dealerships and companies that I want to thank. First off being is Corey with Team CC that stands behind us for the last probably 12 years, I think it is now, and his amazing support makes us very even possible for me and Tyson. And everybody else at Team CC. We got Danny and Barb and everybody else there that makes this race even possible for me and Tyson. As well, we got some amazing other sponsors, people like Sid and BJ with Climb that have supported us greatly this year, and we really appreciate that and make amazing gear. We're very happy to be there. Along with that is some of our Taco Bell, MTA, Global Fuel, guy Trent Carbaugh that as well has helped us for multiple years, Specialty Truck and Auto, and Keith Montenock, which is not only a big supporter of ours, but as Iron Dog as a whole, he does a lot of flying for everybody, and he is a stand-up guy, and an amazing, amazing guy for not only us, but this whole sport. Spence, which was Boy Traction, Northwoods Lodge, which is Tyson's parents. I mean, and I'll let him continue to go with some more.
Yeah, first off, I'd like to thank my wife, Alexis, for letting me do this year after year and supporting me. Our pilots, Keith, Spence, thanks for everything. Spence has been putting in some long hours helping us. Corey at Team CC is, like Tyler said, has been supporting us for years and years. He's always there, always has our back. Ski-Doo, couldn't do it without the sleds. I mean, they hold up amazing. I think it's been proven. Taco Bell, MTA, like Tyler says, also Global Fuel. H&K Sheet Metal Fab, Climb, Sid with Climb Gear. Thanks for taking us. This pretty nice transformation from what we've worn in the past. That's been pretty nice. Stud Boy Traction, that's always a big part of it. IBW, Straight Line Performance. Chris with Alaska LED for providing us with the lights. It's always huge to be able to see at night. Cruise Construction, Alaska Line Builders, Northern Chiropractic, Kyle with Hybrid Color for helping us with some video edits and stuff earlier this year. B&B Transmission, SCS Unlimited for the sled wraps, Grip and Rip Racing, Trail Tanks, RPM Composites, Gates Belts, Doug with Fine Line Interiors, OFT Racing, Fox, and the guys from Hybrid and helping them get some of those shots.
Sounds good for a special mission.
Yeah, he's always into a mission. So, Chris McDowell, Al Palma, John Tovison, Johnny Dean, all the volunteers, communities, everybody that helps out with the Iron Dog and helps put this thing on. People take us into their homes and let us sleep in their beds, on their couches. So that's always very appreciated and couldn't do it without you guys. So thank you.
I actually think one of the other teams here, I don't think Iron Dog's been morphing into this bigger. Everybody's training further and going further and further into these villages. And I think asking more and more of the villages, because a lot of us, as you've seen this year, have traveled all the way to Nome and beyond. And there's one team here, Team 45, Barney, asked a lot of by a lot of teams to do a lot of stuff, and in multiple of the other places, and not only just this week of the race, they take us in for the whole month prior to it, and they're very accepting of it, and the whole community that follows Iron Dog, thank you.
And congrats to Scott and Jim Palin as well.
Departing in the 24th position, team number 10, Mike Morgan and Chris Olds.
All right. First, I want to thank my wife. She's definitely the rock of our family. She's the one that's been with me all 16 years I've raced this race. Thanks, hon. Thanks for supporting me on all these years doing this. Yeah. I'd also like to thank the Iron Dog staff, the people that make this happen. The National Guard for being a big advertiser here, and all the advertisers in the Iron Dog for making this happen. Also, all the volunteers, like people say, this race definitely wouldn't go on without them. I mean, they just, you know, make this thing go.
Open up their homes.
Yep, they open up our homes. They are up all night helping out the racers and race, and it's amazing. Also, like to congratulate the inductees, Scott and Jim. You guys are definitely deserving. I probably wouldn't be racing today if it weren't for Scott. It's his motivation has definitely kept me going. I thought I got into the sport pretty late, so thanks, Scott. Yeah, here's our sponsors.
All right, so I'd like to thank some of our team sponsors here. Polaris Industries has been pretty huge for us over the years, from the engineers to the race department guys, just top-notch guys, get us the parts we need to be successful on these things, and thank you guys. A huge sponsor that stepped up for us this year is Northern Powerline Constructors. Jason Hodges and his team over there helped us out huge this year. We appreciate that. Everybody
Everybody at Climb, Sid and BJ are here. You know, it speaks volume for their gear that the guys that won last year switched from a X brand to Climb, and you know, it's the best. So enough said there. Eagle River Polaris, Sonata Cat, Doug, and Paul over there, they help us out a lot. Walker Evans Racing keep us riding smooth down the trails. Brian and everybody there, huge help getting us some last-minute shocks last week. Thank you, guys. Polaris Engineered Lubricants for keeping us lubed up out there. My Uncle Charlie up in Nome with Q Trucking, huge help. Northern Air Cargo there, they got a bunch of guys here tonight, guys and gals. You know, we just did a training run to Nome last week, and so you know, ship our stuff around for us. Appreciate you guys. My dad, Stan, he's been there flying for us every year. Seven Iron Dogs I've done, he's been flying every single one, so thanks, Pops, for keeping an eye on us. I'll let Chris take a few of these.
Gates Belts, Total Truck and Accessories, Alaska Industrial X-Ray, Todd and the guys at Anchorage Sheet Metal, Bearing Air, Doug Dixon at Fine Line, been using his bags every single race. Stud Boy Traction, Anchorage Drag Bike, Nome Community Center, UIC Construction, United Products.
Yeah, kind of touching on Starting Line there. We're using their vent kits this year, and man, we've ran these sleds through some gnarly alders, and they've held up really well. So pretty impressed with their vent kits that they make. So thank you guys. Like to thank my UA Local 367 Pipe Fitters Union here in Anchorage, Jernstrom Engineering, Aero Twin, Aurora Healthcare Clinic, Morgan Enterprises up in Nome. It's my dad's bus business up there. Always Graphic, Francis, we've been kind of bugging him and harassing him lately, and he's probably getting tired of us, but thank you, Francis, for continuing to answer the phone and such. And Able Body Shop, Northern, Emmons Mechanical up in Nome, Christy Hedrick for doing some brochure work for us, Jeremy Hansen for helping us out in the garage a ton.
Yeah, if it weren't for Jeremy, Jeremy's there every single night helping us out. And same with my buddy Mike Estron. He was there 12 hours putting on wraps yesterday, nonstop. It was pretty impressive.
Yeah, 12 hours, but they look pretty sharp.
Yep.
My mom, Jenny, for pretty much my number one fan supporter.
Thanks,
through
Jenny.
Thick and thin, and pretty awesome there. Hospitality in Nome and everything, and I'd like to thank Larry at Alaska Spine Institute and all his guys there for keeping the spine straight and in line and keeping me rolling down the trail. So have a good race,
yep,
everybody.
Thanks.
Departing in the 25th position, team number 27, Tyler Drake and Shannon Jenkins.
All right, be a little shorter than those guys. girlfriend Maggie, holding down the house and taking care of her son Ivan. My dad, Dwayne, helped me out. Partners, family, putting me up down here, feeding me. Lots of family and friends. Todd Palin, helping us out. St. Michael's Fuel Company, Homes Ready Construction, Woody's Traction Products, Motor Fist, and Chris over at Alaska LED.
To do that last year, so it's been a long year. So I thank you again. Big Lake Power Sports, LuLaRoe Alaska Gal, Superior Products, Franks and Services, Al Palma, Doug Dixon at Fine Line Interior, Randy Kangas, Frankie Harris, Earl and Joyce Summer, Sweetser, Louis Carlo, Alex and Sherry Ivanoff, PK, Renee Egress for putting us up. My sister Verna for coming from Montana to be here tonight. Lots of friends and family in the Yukon and in the villages.
Team number 13, team number 30, team number 7. 13, Paul Johnson.
First and foremost, I'd like to thank my wife and my two sons for supporting me for this. It's been a long haul up here from Minnesota. This is my fourth year. I'd like to say thanks to my mom and dad. Team Arctic, Country Cat, it's been a huge help to us at home. All our other sponsors, they've been a huge help. I'd like to say thanks to the race marshals, all the volunteers that make this thing happen, because it takes a lot of work. Big Lake Arctic Cat, and be safe on the trail.
Bobby and Caden. Some of our sponsors that have really helped us out are the Winning Edge Graphics for our wraps, Climb for our gear, Owen Peterson. Thank you.
Departing in the 27th position, team number 30, Kyle Connor and Jeff Krause.
First of all, honey, I hope you're enjoying your Valentine's Day dinner. Super romantic, and it was expensive, so hope you appreciate it. Thanks for the help. Alaska Boiler and Burner, Norcoast Mechanical, Motor Fist, Vision X Lighting, Cruise Construction, Dave and Dana Cruz, Eagles Quest, Cabins and Lodge out in Willow, Best Breakfast, Grip and Rip Racing, Team 50, Cowbell Nation, Fine Line Interiors, and Donald at Alaska Sheet Metal for making our tanks.
I just want to thank my wife, Jenna, and Blake and Eli for always helping me in the garage and everything else. Thank you for Jared's grandmother for coming up from Florida to watch me race, and my Uncle John from Tennessee, and the rest of my family. Thank you.
Departing in the 28th position, team number 7, Derek Johnson and Craig.
Hello, everybody. I'd like to thank our families, Vern, Tammy, Manette, for opening up their home for us, Interstate Batteries of Alaska. I'd like to thank Andy George, Stephanie George, Brad George, Big Lake Articat, Wasilla Articat, Anchorage Articat, Calvin Nolan. I'd like to thank him. He's put our sleds together for us. And Melissa King for helping us get here. Tickets and travel back and forth. Appreciate that. Anyone else I'm forgetting, Craig?
No, I think that's
it. And all the volunteers, Laurel and Kevin, for the program they put on here. And we look forward to seeing you out there.
Team 44, Team 23, Team 17. Departing the starting line in 29th position, Team 44, Corey Berg and Luke George.
Hello. I'd like to thank my sponsors, Articat, Wasilla Articat, Motor Fist, Mount View Trucking, Security Mini Storage. Let's see, what tattoos and um, Terry Hansen, the long phone calls, the support he's been giving me. Tyrone Brown, Fairweather LLC, that's who I work for up on the slope. Alaska Bedliners, Valley Country Stores, and John Eicher, already said him. Fine Line Interiors, Doug over there, he does great work, been helping us out. And here's Luke.
Well, first of all, I got to thank my parents, Stan and Brenda George. They've been a huge help for me, me and Corey both. My aunt and uncle, Andy and Stephanie George, Team 6, they've helped us out. Wasilla Arctic Cat, Team Arctic Alaska, Security Minute Storage, best parts guy out there. Josh Earhart and all my friends and family who've helped me get this far. Thanks.
Departing in 30th position, team number 23, Chris Cruz and Paul Sindorf.
All right. First off, I'd like to thank Mary and Francie for helping us out this year. Couldn't do it without you guys. And Leon and the fine folks at Academy Mortgage, our primary sponsor, thank you very much. And the folks at Alaska Mining and Diving, David Harris, who did a bunch of the wrenching for us, and the guys up in Nome at Wilderness Skidoo.
First, I'd like to thank Valentine's. I know they're watching. My two boys, Kyle and CJ. Academy Mortgage, like Paul said, our main sponsor. We've got back home, Chase Toys, Josh, Tim and Carrie with Grip and Rip, always a big help. Paul and Mary just for putting me up and helping. Dave Harris, like he said, working on the sleds, and just all the other people it takes to get us out here. Thank you.
Departing in 31st position, team number 17, Chad Guaco and Dusty Van Meter.
Skidoo, appreciate all the help. Corey at Team CC, couldn't do it without you guys providing the best sleds that I've ever ridden. Fox Shocks, stud boy Ron Patton, always a huge help. I've been with him for a long time. Well Solutions, Motor Fist, Mike and Brock, helping us out for years and years. Body Renew, Brian Horschel and my trainer John Anthony for attempting to get me in shape. Bills Distributing, Tony Webster, he's been behind me for a long time. Project 907 for killing the wraps this year, we really appreciate it. Alaska LED, Chris, thank you for the continued support and keeping the daylight out in front of us no matter the hour. Terriers, always a huge help, and I think everybody uses him, builds the best bags there is. Compost, Skidoo, Wilderness for keeping us going on the trail and helping us out. Seth with Trail Tank, Gates Belts, and Mr. Carpick. My mother and father, Danny, Dad, thanks for staying in the shop with me hours and hours and hours and arguments and just interruptions, and that's how it goes. But this one's for you, Pop. And my wife, for letting me take her on this dream date to an iron-on banquet on Valentine's Day. Thank you.
Gotta make that a little. I'm just gonna add a couple of repeats here because Corey and Barb have been behind me for many years, a lot of help, and Hal and Jerry also is a big supporter of theirs, which is a supporter of ours as well. I'd like to thank Chad's wife too for putting up with me when I come down and invade their home. My wife, my kids, for putting up with me to do this again when I told them I wasn't gonna do it anymore. I'd like to add Louis Restaurant, GLM Machine. My company I work for is Tesoro. I'd like to congratulate Jim. Not only was he a big part in getting this race back together, he was a big support in a few wins that I've had also. Scott Davis, top competitor. Just kidding. I like seeing Bob Kowalki, which is a huge supporter of mine when this all first started. So, and then all the volunteers and National Guard and people we stay with out there is just amazing. So, good luck, everybody.
And just to reinstate, Bob, it's a face I haven't seen in a very long time, and you're a huge contributor to my entire race career when I was just a kid on Yamaha, so thank you.
Team number 24. Team number 20. Second position, team number 24, Scott Franz and Nathan Haynes.
We're kind of hoping for last, but, you know, we'll take whatever we get. I want to start with thanking Corey and Barbara, Team CC, the passion that he has for this race, and Skidoo, the manufacturer. I mean, I haven't seen anything like it. He was out there Sunday. We had huge issues. And panic, and this was literally a couple days ago, and he spent the entire day with us, and we rebuilt our shocks and made everything go right, and I can't say how happy and I am to be on Team CC and the support they've given us. You know, Scott Davis, thank you for his support. AJ Bartell, I can't say enough, and Gordon Bartell flying for us, but AJ, you know, his experience has been phenomenal. And try and do it your rookie year. It's a lot, and everybody knows that who's in this room who's run it, and I have a lot of respect for the people that come before me. It's a very humbling experience so far, and I can only imagine what the race itself is going to be like. It is an epic, epic race, so I look forward to doing that. Sponsor-wise, got to go down the list. BC Excavating, big help. Rupp Financial, David Rupp, he's one of my best friends and a great, great guy. Phenomenal guy for your insurance needs, investments, the whole deal. Kaufman Engineers, my brother, he's an engineer over there, principal, owner. Great outfit. Team CC again, Container Specialties, Loken Crane and Rigging. Same deal. Rainproof Roofing, Pat Riley, thank you very much. DNS Concrete, Alaska Signs and Barricades. CMI Construction Machinery, they've always treated us well over the years. Northrum Benefits Group, Arctic Pension Services, Resident Hunters of Alaska. I don't know how many of you are members of that group. They're a great organization. Just like this race, they're all about Alaska. This is they're an organization that really represent the Alaskan hunter. So if you're not part of it, look into it. I gotta say thank you to my wife as well. She's been a rock. She actually gave me a pass on Valentine's Day, so says she, I can make it up to her. So she's the same. Yeah. There you go. I don't know if you got
anything. First off, thanks to Corey, Team CC again. Thanks for the help, Scott Davis, and AJ Bartell with the unlimited knowledge that they've helped us with. Through everything, my girlfriend for the support, my family back home in Colorado. They've been with me through everything, and but also our sponsors that made this possible. I mean, we got Buckmeyer Enterprises, a couple of friends out of Fairbanks, FS&G Aggregate, Climb has helped us out tremendously. Scott Goggles, been one of my sponsors for years. LifeProof Cases, IXL Technologies, GoPro, all that have been there. Chris, huge friend and help up in Fairbanks, now down here giving us lights. We got Al Palma building light brackets and tanks and everything. Thank you. 139 Designs, Arctic Pension, Gates Belts again, Stud Boy, CMI, everybody. Thank you. Thanks for the help.
Doug and Fine Line. Thanks too, Doug. See you guys.
Departing in the 33rd position, number 20, Todd.
Well, I want to congratulate my dad for his Hall of Fame inductee tonight, and then Scott. It was an honor to ride with you all those years. You're just you're one of the best. In that corner over there with Kawaki and all the old guys in the foundation of this race, it's good to see all of you. Eagle River Polaris is a big sponsor of ours. Walker Evans Racing, NRA Sports, hiring our heroes, Sid with Climb, Al Palma, he really did a number on our motors. Thank you, Al. Hopefully they run good. And to thank my wife and family for allowing me to continue to do this, but also thank Darcy Quam for giving the green light for Eric to come out of retirement on short notice. So thank you.
Yeah, I got to thank my wife for letting me do this. Thank Todd for, I guess, getting me out of retirement. Going out 33, I don't know about that, though. I got to thank Doug with Fine Line Interiors. We were kind of an expedited schedule here, and he knocked some bags out right away for us. He's always there for us, and it's great. You know, Dan Risner with Shocks helping us out this year has been awesome. Brad Helwig spent the weekend wrenching on sleds, getting us ready, which was awesome. Got to congratulate Scott and Jim. That's awesome. Another thing a lot of people don't realize with the Iron Dog, the group doesn't really invest a lot of money and resources in breaking trails. So there's been a handful of teams that have been out there this year making it possible to have a trail. You know, Todd and Nick spent a lot of effort breaking trail, trying to get the trail into Pontilla. And then we had Tyson and Tyler with the Iron Dog Air Force dropped a chainsaw into Roan so that they ended up cutting trees going from basically Roan Roadhouse to Egypt Mountain. There's, you know, the burn through there, it's burnt through there, and so all the trees, when the wind blows, they all kind of go down like matchsticks, and so you can't just ride around the trees. You got to cut them to get through there, and those guys worked real hard making that trail possible. We were going to be there with them, but we had a little challenge, so we were a day behind them. Coming back. And we got to thank all the people out in the different villages that aren't here tonight. They don't necessarily hear it, but they make this race possible. They, you know, let us come into their homes. They go out, break trail. They spend their money on fuel, and they make the race possible. And us racers really, really appreciate that.
I forgot to mention Alaska Directional is a big sponsor of ours. And thanks to Hatch Pass Polaris, you always guys have been great helping out with parts and everything.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is the final team of our early bird drawing. Our final two fourth position, team number 15, Charlie Potter and Alex Schwackert.
It's better late than never. First off, I'd like to thank our races. Carl and Melanie, they let me go unlock the shop anytime I wanted. stay there as long as they want. Make sure you lock it up. Anchorage Suzuki Arctic Cat, Brad, he's full of information. Fact, Abel Locksmith, Motor Fist Gear, Trail Tanks. Called him a week ago and he sent me two tanks. CW Tack and Western Wear, Hatcher's Pass Polaris, Big Dipper Clothing Company, Stacy Allen with State Farm, Micah Huss, I call him, complain, ask questions, he gives me an answer, thank you. Clap Peterson Law, TCC and Danny Guaco, need some shocks done, Danny got them done, and let Alex finish it up.
I got to start with thanking my wife and my three kids. Couldn't do this without their support. Carl at Big Lake Arctic Cat, huge help. Howard Concrete Services, Grizzly LED and Design for the lights. The Thomas Company, Pro Excavation, Blue Arctic Waste, Diversified Tire. Tom Whitstein for the shocks. Brian Jarenka for wrenching on my sled when I'm at home with my kids. Clint Van Wiggerden for the knowledge and the help with training. And our family and friends. Without everyone, this wouldn't be possible.
Departing in 35th position, team number 19, Harold Edis.
Alrighty, I'd like to thank McKinley Players, Vision X, Yukon Cargo, Gerald James, Audrey Blyfoot, Wright's Air Service, Darby's Performance, Woody's, Walker Evans, and my parents, Margaret and Wilmer.
All right, I'd like to, first of all, thank Archie for coming with me here, and I'd like to thank my girlfriend, Tiffany. Thanks, sweetie. Happy Valentine's Day. I'd also like to congratulate Scott Davis. Yes, sir, but I'd like to also congratulate you, Jim Palin, correct? At any rate, I think I'm not quite sure what might inspire someone to race the Iron Dog or become competitive in sports and such. I've been actually in a different sport, in boat racing for years, for 30 years. And seeing Scott Davis, you know, enter into the Hall of Fame and such is real impressive. Not quite really hard and difficult and grueling. I think everybody had dreams of winning the Iron Dog, or there was a show. I'm old enough to remember ABC Sports and Howard Cosell, and at the intro, some folks may remember, but the thrill of victory and the agony of defeat, I believe that was the intro to the ABC Sports, and each rider and participant is always dreaming of winning, and a lot of times there's that agony of defeat, and that's probably what you make you come back for more and try and participate. And for some folks, it might be individual. Thank some of the folks along the trail, breaking trail. I was up there toward the coast, and Smilka, Devon Smilka from Caltag. Larry Breederman, Arnold Marks and Tanana, some of the pit crew, Leo Williams, Herbie Moses, Ron Bedis, Don and Shailene Greenway and Ruby for putting us up there, Terrence and Val up in the Unicleat, and we hope to be somewhat competitive and be a far reach to say we hope to be competitive here, and wish everybody a safe race. one of my friends, Ro, up in Fairbanks. I was visiting him. I'm going to go run to Iron Dog. He wasn't so impressed, I guess. But I was leaving his house, and he told me, hey, yeah, go like hell and take lots of chances. That's what he told me. So we'll try and take some of his advice, and we'll see you folks in Fairbanks. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's have one more round of applause for all of our pro class. And please, let's have a round of applause for Tara Mogan with the USO and Laurel Hickel for drawing our racers tonight. I'd like to thank you all for coming. I'd like to remind you about some upcoming events. Tomorrow we will be at Cabela's for the Tech Inspection and the Donlin Gold Safety Expo. And then we'll see you on Friday and Saturday for the Flying Iron Freestyle shows and on 4th Avenue for the ceremonial start. Thank you all very much for coming. Please drive safe.
Iron Dog would like to thank all the sponsors and volunteers that have helped make this year's race a success. Premier sponsors, Donlin Gold, Kendall Toyota, GCI, XPS Oil, Northern Air Cargo, Monster Energy, Climb, Alaska Directional, Raven Alaska, Hatcher Pass Polaris, along with Alaska Spine Institute and the Pro Class sponsors, and all of our great supporters and sponsors. Thank you for your support of the 2017 Iron Dog Race.